Hey everyone, this is George Couros with a solo episode of the Innovator's Mindset podcast. My goal for some of these podcasts is just to kind of look back at some of the email newsletters that I've written and maybe just kind of talk them out, hopefully provide some advice, some guidance, maybe a few stories about why I wrote them and kind of the behind the scenes. And what I'm going to talk about today is an email that I wrote on three tips for getting a new job. You're probably listening to this at a point where you might be applying for a new job. You might be thinking about leaving your current position. And my advice to you would be this. Don't stay in a place where you don't feel valued. Don't stay in a place where you don't feel appreciated. I know from experience that there's sometimes you're in a job, an organization that you've kind of hit your peak where you're not maybe going to aspire to some of the goals that you have. And it's not necessarily because of the people. It's not necessarily because of the organization. It just is what it is. And you know what? Maybe it is because of some of the people. Maybe it is because of the organization. I can't honestly tell you that. I don't know your situation as you're listening to this. But from experience, I know that no matter what you aspire to in some places, they will continuously look at you as the person you were when you started, not the person you are now. And maybe that's human nature. Maybe that's what, you know, is just par for the course. That's just what it is. But I at one point in my career felt that as much as I tried to, and I can honestly say this, when I was at the one organization that I'm referencing, that I was not really interested in teaching as much. I remember actually in my interview, the principal said, and they were like desperate to hire a teacher because no one really wanted to come out there. They said, it feels like you're more interested in coaching basketball than you are in teaching. And I was like, that's probably true. It's probably true. I didn't lie. I didn't pretend that was something else. I looked at teaching, being in education, as a job. Is something just that would pay my bills and something I could do, but it wasn't something I was really inspired to do. And that's kind of how I started. But as I progressed in my personal and professional life, I wanted more. I really started getting really invested in education, but I felt that, and maybe this is my perception, but perception is often reality, that I was going to be held back to what I was when I started, not where I was mentally, with my dedication to the job, to the field, that I was not going to maybe get new opportunities, new things. I was kind of pigeonholed to something else. So sometimes you just need a fresh start and you need a new space. And again, this has nothing to do with that organization. I can kind of understand it a little bit, but it was also just wasn't for me. And I wanted to start fresh. I wanted a new opportunity. And I started actively looking for a job. And when I got a job, I still wasn't really invested in education. I couldn't really tell you I was really passionate about the profession. But then I came into it saying, look, I have a blank slate. I can recreate myself, this new opportunity. Nobody knows me here. And I can kind of become whatever I want to be. And basically, I went from not being interested in education to being so passionate about it and quickly becoming an assistant principal, then a principal, and, you know, moving to central office and now doing the work that I do, working with organizations all over the world, which is such a blessing. And that wouldn't have happened if I wasn't willing to leave a job. Not that I got a new job, but I was willing to leave something. And I can tell you that probably for 2-3 years prior to leaving, I just kind of complained, was bothered by it, but I wasn't really doing anything to change the situation. I knew that there was kind of, it was kind of like a dead end for me. I wasn't going to aspire to or have the opportunity to kind of blossom in the role unless something drastically changed in the organization. And I don't think that's a organization thing. I don't like pointing at anyone else other than myself. I just feel maybe I just started off on the wrong foot and just kind of need a new opportunity. And one of the quotes that I'm known for that I really try to live my life by is change an opportunity, something amazing. But are you waiting for the change to happen to you, or are you actually going to create it yourself. And that's what I actually did. And it led to just a way better quality of life professionally and personally. And I'm so glad that I was willing to leave instead of just complaining about being somewhere. Because I honestly don't know what my life would look like if I stayed. I probably would not be in education, that's for sure. Or involved with it in any way. And who knows what would happen. So I think sometimes getting a new job is not so much about having that new opportunity, but leaving something you know is not going to serve you anymore. And whether that's actually staying in the field or leaving the field, you know, I hear people saying like, oh, like I hate education, or, you know, this is not the job for me, then leave. I know it's a harsh thing to say, but don't stay where you're miserable. That just, you don't have to find a new job, but don't stay where you're miserable. You have to leave if you're miserable. So that to me is something that I'm really trying to help people with too, is like, you got to initiate your own change. So that all being said, kind of just sharing a little backstory why this is something I'm really passionate about, I want to just kind of give you three tips and ideas. And I wrote these points down. You can actually read the entire newsletter. And I'm going to read the points, but just kind of talk off the top of my head. And if you're looking for a new opportunity, this was really great advice that was given to me, is that you need to create a resume aligned with the job or career you want, not the one you currently have. So here's an example of this. Kelly Wilkins, who basically was the inspiration behind the book, What Makes a Great Principal, she was absolutely an amazing principal, the biggest influence on my professional career. She actually, I remember applying for an assistant principal position, and I was teaching at the time. And what she had said to me was, I asked her, I said, well, how would I shape my resume? Like, this is totally new to me. And I'll be honest with you, I had no interest in going into administration ever. It just kind of happened. And then as soon as I started, I absolutely loved it. It was a really incredible opportunity. I felt that I kind of found something that really suited where I was at the time and, you know, some of my strengths. And she said to me that, you know, where we are, and that was Alberta, Canada, we have what's called the leadership standard. I think it was the principal quality standard. What you need to do is look at those standards, and there was like 7 standards that were expected of principals at the time, and then show how you meet those standards from the viewpoint of a teacher. So if building relationships, that's one of them. How do you do that as a teacher already, right? How do you actually have visionary, how are you visionary in the field of education? So basically what she was telling me was, prove to them that in your current position, you're already meeting the expectations of the job, that this is kind of a no-brainer for you. So let's say you want to move from a teaching position, one district to the other. Look at how they evaluate teachers, what their expectations are, and then actually align the resume to that. The best way I can kind of summarize this really, really quickly is, like an old adage, is the idea that dress to the job you want, not the job you have. And really kind of aligning your resume, your vision, your hopes to the job that you aspire to be. And just kind of figuring out where do I want to be? What are they looking for in that position? How do I align that? And that really, really helped me. But it also, I know this sounds weird, it also made me feel very confident going into it, because I'm like, I know how to do this stuff because this is what they're asking. I'm already doing this in my role. So I think that was something that was really, really helpful to me. And I love resharing that advice, because Kelly, when she shared that with me, it was just groundbreaking in how it changed my thinking. And so the next one is research where you want to go and highlight their work and how it aligns with yours. So this is a really important thing, that when you go, first of all, if you're applying for a job, before you even apply, look, don't just say, oh, this is a perfect position. Well, it might be a perfect position at a terrible place. So that's not something you want to necessarily have, because, you know, a really good position in a bad organization is not a good position. So before you even apply, kind of just think about, like, is this somewhere I want to be? And it's so easy to actually do this. I would not just look at, you know, don't just limit your search to like a school website, because here's what I'm gonna tell you. Every school website says the school is awesome, because you know why? Because the school is making the website. They're not gonna say, yeah, we're all right. They're not gonna say, you know, where their weaknesses are. But look at their vision, their mission, you know, some of the things that are happening in their schools. But also look at the news, like Google that school name, look at the news, some of the things are happening. That will tell you a lot about the organization that you have. And then if you're like, you know what, this is a place where I wanna be. This is how I want to to kind of, you know, this is the work that can kind of, you know, really push me to the next level. I think when you're in that interview, part of it is make sure that you actually let them know you know them through how you answer your questions, how you have the conversation, how you share this, but then really highlight how you're going to bring that vision to the next level. Here's something I do currently as someone who's asked to come in and speak and consult. Before I even get on a phone call or have a conversation with these groups, I'll Google them and I'll look them up. I'll see what their vision is. And then I'll say, hey, I actually read this. This is really something that I appreciate. And I wouldn't say that unless it was true. Here's how my work aligns with this. So it makes you, it shows that you really did your research and that you're trying to understand who you're serving. But also it's like, hey, how do I join you to actually bring you to the next level? That's kind of, I think, will kind of separate you from other people, is really kind of making sure that you know them and they know you. A little side story. When I was a principal, I remember asking this question, and we were very focused on how we use technology in meaningful ways. This was all over. You could see it on social media. You could see it on our website. And I asked the question for, it was a grade 2 position. And I asked the question, how would you use technology at the grade 2 level? And the response was, I don't think kids that young should be using this. And I was thinking, I don't think you looked up our school, right? Because we are already very actively using this. And this is not a conversation on whether kids should be using it or not, but it was just, you know, why, like, did you even look us up before you came here? And then I asked questions, and I think, you know, if the answer was, you know, I know you're really, this is something that's big, but I actually don't necessarily agree with it. Here's why. I would have been way more open to that, because at least I know you kind of knew what you're getting into. I asked the question, well, what level do you think kids should be using this? And it's grade 3. That was the response I received. So I asked her, I said, okay, so we might have a grade 3 position. What would you do then? And then she said, well, I actually don't necessarily agree with it then. So basically it was like, I just don't believe kids should be using this at all, or I don't necessarily want to do it. So it was kind of a disconnect in, I don't really know if you know much about us, who we are. And it kind of threw me off. And I don't necessarily think that my vision or what our school is doing is 100% right and we can't learn from others. But at least reference so people know that you know what you're getting into, what you're kind of looking at. Because if this was a big focus for us and it was like, nah, I don't want to do this, then obviously our, you know, our visions and our goals are not aligned, and that's going to cause issues down the line. So just really kind of understanding the organization and who you serve. And so the last one I'm going to share is focus on a few of your strengths and try to relate them to how they would benefit the new role or organization. This is really something that I really try. This is kind of feels like a little politician-y, and I'm a little bit nervous about that because I don't mean to come off this way at all. But when you think about what you're really good at, what you excel at in your work, and we all have strengths, before you enter an interview, before you maybe put in an application or show a resume or share a portfolio, really think about, like, what are 2 or 3 things that you are amazing at, that you're really, really good at, and write them down somewhere. This is something I do all the time, is like, what are like the key points I'm going to keep coming back to? And in that interview process, can you kind of go back to reference that? So you know, and you can communicate what you're really good at and how it will benefit them, what your strengths are. And the thing is that some of the questions you ask, they'll always kind of tailor back to what you're really good at, how you connect with that. But just kind of have that in mind. Have that in the back of your head, because sometimes when we walk an interview, and I don't think this is the best process, but it is still standard practice, is people have interview questions and we're kind of thrown off because we don't know what we're expecting. And then we just kind of answer in a certain way, but we don't really highlight what we're good at. And I think just kind of writing that down, having the back of your mind, is a great way to kind of accentuate what you do really well and how it can benefit them. So just kind of have that in the back of your mind as you enter those spaces. So just kind of going back, the 3 points I shared are, you know, create a resume or application aligned with the job or career you want, not the one you currently have. Research where you want to go and highlight the work and how it aligns with yours. And the last one, focus on a few of your strengths and try to relate them to how they would benefit the new role or organization. So I just want to share that with you. Here's what I will tell you. And I kind of going back to the beginning. Don't stay in a place you don't feel valued. I know I said this already, but I'm just reiterating it, that if you're waiting for someone else to make your life better, you could be waiting for a long time. But if you actually want to make your life better, you can start this at this moment. This, if you're kind of stuck right now and you're listening to this and you're like, yeah, I don't like where I'm working, I'll change it and change it. That's up to you. You know, if you wait for someone else, you're going to be waiting forever. I think the best way to create change in our lives is to initiate ourselves. So I wish you the best. If you listen this long, you're probably kind of like, maybe I should look for a new job. So I wish you the best. And hopefully some of the advice I can share with you, you got to make it your own, can help you in that pursuit. I know for me, leaving a position was a door that opened for me that I never imagined could have such an impact. So I think sometimes the new opportunities do not come to us unless we're willing to walk away from the old. So best of luck to you. I hope this helped. Have a wonderful day. Thanks for all you do. Take care.